Drugs, sex, alcohol, many of today's teenagers are into it all. But if you think there's no hope for the next generation, you're about to meet a man who says, think again.
Today's young people face a sobering future. Morality has gone down the tubes, the economy's a mess, and the business of politics continues to polarize the nation. Some say there's no hope for America's future generations. Others, like Lou Engle, disagree. He's the founder of The Call, a series of prayer events that have drawn young people from around the country to fast and pray for revival. Well, he's at it again, bringing young people together for The Call DC. It's a day of prayer and fasting in our nation's capital.
Please welcome back to the 700 Club, the founder of The Call, Lou Engle. Boy, it's great to see you again.
Thank you. It's great to be here.
Wonderful to have you with us. Your website says that this event is a fast, not a festival. Explain that.
Well, Terry, the vision of this was Joel chapter 2. I had a dream in 1996. And in this dream, I was with these leaders of this prayer movement, and there was a little boy named Joel. And I was supposed to be giving him a letter, but I had lost the letter, and I was frantically looking for it. And I woke up out of the dream, and the Lord spoke to me, said, don't lose Joel's letter. Call the youth of America to fasting and prayer, chapter 2 of Joel. When there's no hope for a nation, blow the trumpet, call a fast, gather all the inhabitants, and afterward I will pour out my spirit. United massive fasting and prayer is God's prescription when there is no hope. Yeah. And the kids and adults are gathering together seeking His face with fasting.
You know, fasting makes such a difference. You've really impacted my life with that. Even as you started The Call, there were things God called me to fast for in those days that I saw a radical move of the hand of God in. You've been doing The Call for many years. You took a little bit of a break for a couple of years, started again last summer in Nashville. This second wave of events, what's the message? What's the heart of what you're doing?
Well, in many ways, it's the same thing. We are on a march to revival, consecration, holiness, and purity. But we're also going after, we believe that God's going to end abortion. We believe that God's going to raise up a million adoptions. This is what we're crying out, that the church would be the answer to the family issues of the nation. And so on August 16th, we're calling the whole nation back. We want to call all the Promise Keepers men. Come back, renew your vows to the Lord. All those kids who are at The Call DC, where 400,000 gather, come back and renew your vows. It's not too late. Let's believe that we're going to see the greatest awakening in the history of America, even now.
And significant that you're in Washington, D.C. at this time with these issues. You mentioned abortion, you mentioned adoption. What else is on your heart as far as issues are concerned?
Well, we're also seeking to gather together the races. I'm believing God with a man named Harry Jackson that we're going to see the integration of the church in the next 10 years. Amen. The church will lead the way. I believe what's going on, even in the elections, God is exposing things, but He wants to raise up voices of unity, of love, forgiveness. I think the church needs to lead the parade of history. Amen. In reconciliation and prayer and fasting together.
You know, God's word tells us that pure religion is taking care of widows and orphans. How did you get to the adoption issue, and what is your heart for that?
Well, we just realized we're praying for 3 years for the ending of abortion in front of the Supreme Court. We've got two judges now. Partial birth abortion has been banned. Mm-hmm. But it's not enough just to say we're going to end abortion. The fact is, pregnant women have great pain in their lives, crisis pregnancies. And who's going to care for all the babies? The movies are all prophesying in Hollywood that adoption's a better answer to abortion. 7 movies this year. Hollywood is shouting. Horton Hears a Who. A person's a person, no matter how small, and every voice must be counted. We're saying, I believe the church is going to want the children. It's Malachi. He'll turn the hearts of the fathers to the children and the children to their fathers. I'm believing for it. And we're seeing it wherever we go after these calls. We're getting reports of people going back and adopting their babies. Adopting babies, it's phenomenal. I get
so
excited.
Awesome. It is. You know, it's so easy in the world today, Lou, to be steered away from the things that matter. Life is busy. People's schedules are crazy. And when you talk about hearing the call and even naming your event The Call, there is a call of God to the hearts and the ears of those who will listen. What What is God wanting to accomplish spiritually in us?
Well, I think the original word that God gave to us was gather the Nazarites to the mole, which is an Old Testament term for extreme consecrated ones. Wherever I go in America now, young people are fasting and praying. It gives me joy that what we've been doing is not in vain. Now 24/7 houses of prayer are springing up in universities. Kids are hungering for God. I think we're in the ground level. There's a rumble of revival. All the stadiums, I dreamed that stadiums would be filled with fasting and praying 10 years ago. I'm living in the answer to my dreams, and I've got to believe God is going to pour out His Spirit in all this prayer and this passion for Jesus.
I know that you're going to be involved in an event in Jerusalem, a call event there. Tell me about that and what your vision for that is.
May 11th, we're at the 60th anniversary of Israel becoming a nation. God TV and Global Day of Prayer and The Call are uniting, and we're calling for a global Joel 2 encounter experience, for an Acts 2 encounter. Mm-hmm. And we're believing that God's going to pour out His Spirit on the Jewish peoples.
You know, I want to say to people who are listening that even if you can't be in Jerusalem, even if you can't be in Washington, D.C., you can hear the call and be part of the call. People can be praying, they can be fasting with you, even if they're not able to actually go to the location. The location isn't the issue, it's the subject.
Yeah.
The subject is Jesus and the truth. The Call D.C. is happening August 16th in Washington, D.C., and we thank you for what you're doing. It's awesome to have you
Terry,
here.
Thank you. They can go to thecall.com, get all the information they need.
That's easy enough.
Thank you.
Well, it's a wonderful opportunity to have your voice be heard in our nation's capital. I think throughout the program today, you've seen things that have been happening in cities around America. You've heard what's going on in the news around the world. Never before has it been so important for the voice of the church to rise up, to take a stand for truth. And you can do that on your own, in your home. Read the Word. Get into God's Word. And then pray along with all of these people who are a part of the call. And if you can, join them. August 16th, Washington, D.C., thecall.com. Thank you.
Thank you,
Terry. God bless you. Great to have you with us.